today on the first day of August. I'm going to go back to my index.html file from last time. I'm going to run it in the browser to remind myself what it looks like. Remember to open up your console view. What's the keyboard shortcut for the console? F12, yes. So remember to open up F12 in the browser so you can see some of that console.log output and errors. We didn't have to look at that screen very much this semester because it's JavaScript where this is the most valuable to see messages, errors, and so forth. So what I've got so far, battle, you get a random character, hero and villain with random power levels, 79 to 76, output here that we're giving ourselves. So the next thing that we need to do is we need to have JavaScript determine who won. We have these power levels that are generated, then we have to say, okay, this number is more than this number, this character is more powerful than that character. So we'll go back to the function. All of this is happening in the function. Pick a random character, create their power, show them on screen. Before we show them on screen, we have to do one thing. So let's back up. There's that line 50 or so that is displaying the result, or not the result, but that is displaying the characters, their matchup, who versus who. Well, the way we can make choices or decisions or get results is through a variety of set of conditional statements. Conditional statements. Can make decisions. Put decisions in quotes because, again, this is when we realize how dumb computers are. They don't know what we want unless we tell them exactly what we want. So this decision, a human decision, is obvious. But a computer-based decision is very, very simple, which actually can make it complicated. Mm-hmm. Because the only thing a computer can decide on is true or false. Yes or no. On or off, 0 or 1. So the binary aspect of computers then tells us we need to think basically like a computer, yes or no. Okay, if you think about it in the real world, if I'm hungry, I'm gonna go eat. Right, I'm hungry at the moment, I'm gonna go to the cafeteria. That's a decision. So breaking it down, computer logic, yes or no. Are you hungry, true or false? If it's true, I'm hungry, go eat. If it's false, I'm not hungry, don't eat. So conditional statements make decisions. Based on, I'm going to do this on multi lines, based on true or false, yes, no, on, off, 0 or 1. Conditional statements can make decisions based on true or false premise. I may ask in a human readable or a human question, did Spider-Man beat Dr. Doom in this case? Yes. No. What's the answer? Did Spider-Man beat Dr. Doom at the moment? Nope. He's only got power 64. He's got power 99. Here's another one. Did Invisible Woman beat Dr. Doom at the moment? Yes, this time. Her number is higher than his number. So, you're thinking in terms of, did this first character beat that first character? Is this first number greater than this second number? That's how we're going to make a decision of who won. We might think about, we look at here, we say, Dr. Doom won. Well, that's going to be a different kind of question to ask, because we can only have true or false. So to think basically like a computer, we pick one and ask the question. Did Squirrel Girl win, yes or no? Clearly not. So is this number greater than this number, yes or no, true or false? And that's how we make our condition. In the condition that something is true, you get a result. In the condition that it's false, you get another result. So I'm going to create, we're going to create an if, else statement, checks. You have many kinds of conditional statements. This is one of the basic ones. If something is true, you do something, or else it's false, and you do something else. So the syntax of this, if, open close parentheses, space, curly brace, close your curly brace next line, space, else, open curly brace, close curly brace. This is the basic structure, the basic skeleton of an if-else statement. If something is true, do something, or else it's false, do something else. Say check if the above is true. If it is, run the code, and this will work. Or else, it's false. So, run the code. One or the other. We're going to ask a question, basically, and if it's true, do the stuff in this block only. Don't do the else. Okay, we check something, and it's actually false. That number is less than that number. So we skip, the code skips, the processor skips down to else, and does what's in the else block only. It's either or. And in these blocks, you can have hundreds of lines of code, thousands. You can have functions in these. You can build a whole world of code within an if and an else. So what we're going to check for is if something is true. Check if the above is true. This always checks if it's true. Almost every programming language will check an if statement. It will evaluate it. Is this true? So let's say this. We need to check the power level of the first character and against the power level of the other character. So random power hero is the hero's power level. So we'll put that in the if statement, space, greater than symbol, which is the right angle bracket. We use that right angle bracket in HTML as part of a tag, but here we're using it as a plain old greater than symbol. Remember in math, 2 greater than 1. The number 2 is more than the number 1, obviously, 2 greater than 1. So here we're then checking, is the random power hero greater than the random power villain? This is the question that we're asking. hero's power of more than, greater than, the villain's. Well, that means we want to display that the character won, the hero won. We're thinking in terms of that one dimension. Did the hero win or lose? So we've got a div to display the result of who won. Right, we have up on the HTML div winner, which we created a JavaScript object of, L div winner. And we've been displaying on screen in the LDIV characters, we've been displaying who's battling. We want to show now the result. We'll say LDIV winner dot inner HTML equals something. It'll have a semicolon. Okay, so here we're checking that the hero versus the villain. Is the hero's power more than the villain's? Yes. So we'll say that hero won, in quotes. It could be that the number is generated, 98 versus 12. That's a true. It could be the numbers are 7 versus 50. So then, is 7 greater than 50? No. False. So that means it skips the true block and goes to the false block. And here we'll say, hero lost. That div I kind of did it quickly without really mentioning it, but notice the way I wrote it here. This is how I write it in the real world, because I know a complete statement has the semicolon at the end, and I'm going to write this in quotes, so I have the opening and closing quote, and then I'll fill in the detail. When I teach coding, I always try to talk about how when you have a pair of something, square brackets, write your pair right away, your quotes right away, because it's very easy to forget the other half of it when you're writing a lot of code. Run that. In this case, Invisible Woman versus Venom, 4 to 54, hero lost. See the number. 4 is less than 54. So the question was asked, is 4 greater than 54? False. So it jumped to the else portion, the else block. Run that again. Invisible Woman 90, Dr. Doom 66. Is 90 greater than 66? True. So you run the first block. And you have all these battles. Squirrel Girl versus Galactus. Number one. Just like in the comics, that one issue, which you beat Galactus. So it's working. The logic of it. We're thinking in terms of true or false. We have these power levels associated with the characters, and then we check, is one power greater than the other? True or false? True block, false block. It says generically hero won or hero lost, and this works just fine. But let's say we wanted to get creative, and we wanted it to say Squirrel Girl won, or Squirrel Girl lost, or, you know, Squirrel Girl won, or Galactus won. We wanted to say the character who actually won. Our code is generic. It says hero won. We wanted to say the name of the character. change that to the array heroes. The current hero is random number hero. That'll work, right? From the array, I'm getting the current hero, and I'm saying that hero 1. That works. And in the quotes.
It's in the quotes.
Exactly. So that's a string now. That's going to display, literally, the code arrays, brackets, random number hero. So you guys help me out. How do I fix this? Yes. First, remove the starting quote, and then array of heroes plus quote. We get the space because it will show the character plus the word one exactly as is with no space. I want a space. Now, the current hero, this random number, it's not random every single instance, it's random every single click. So once you click, the random number is created, and it's in memory, and we use this several times. Out to the console output, out to the inner HTML, and then for the winner, too. Say it that way, as in thinking in terms of the hero winning or losing, or simply who won or lost. Because I'm thinking about it here in terms of the hero has won, the hero has lost. You could write the else block, naming the villain that won. Both of those ways work. Do that. So I don't misspell it, because I have a tendency to forget if I put plural or not. There it is, array villains plus. I want to say I want it to stand out, capital letters there, lowercase letters there. So in this case I'm saying, well, I'm naming that the villain has won, rather than naming that the hero has lost. Both of those would work just fine. It's just a matter of preference. Do I want to show that the hero has won or lost? Or do I simply want to state who has won? So in this case, Venom 1. Doom 1. Doom 1 again. Squirrel 1. Oh, it should be Dr. Doom again, like in that other issue of the comic. So, there's a hero battle. Visually, very, very, very plain, boring, but conceptually, in the code, stripping away all of our comments, we probably have around 30 lines of JavaScript, and 10 or so lines of HTML. And all of this JavaScript is doing a variety of things, putting variables, list of characters, activating buttons that will do something, and then the logic of checking who won. So that's that. Any questions before we get to what the homework is? Final homework. This is our project. Did that work for everyone? Yes. Good eye. It wasn't in order, this final one, and it worked just fine. The answer about does it have to be in order, it's going to depend on what you're trying to do. on some things it has to be in a specific order, and for other things like this it didn't have to be. So notice, we create all of this stuff, we check who won, and we are displaying who won before we display who's battling, and that worked just fine. If we move, you don't have to do this, but if I move it, right? If I move that first hero versus villain before the if else, it'll work exactly the same. So in this case, it did not matter the order. But in other cases, it definitely matters because you have to do something logically before something else can happen. Technically, it doesn't matter if we display in the code who versus who before we show who wins. Works. It processes it so fast, it displays both like at once, kind of. But other time, definitely, case by case basis, the order matters. So maybe just for the logic of it, if you would all like, you could put show the characters match up first, and then show who won second. Both will work. But here, maybe conceptually, makes sense. What appears on the screen is what appears in my code. Any other questions about the project? Yes.
What happens to the off chance that the powers are
we didn't account for that, and we should also. In the other class, we do. When I teach this, I do cover that. That possibility, what happens if they match. So yeah, we could get a 22 versus 22. Right now we have no condition to check for that. We are only checking less than or greater than, but there is equality. There could be Spider-Man 22 versus Venom 22. We could get that.
Would you just add another else statement?
Something like that, we would. Let's go ahead and add it. Let's say, okay, let's deal with what happens if we have the exact same result.
A draw.
There's no when. Not in JavaScript. In other languages, there could be. So we can check for more than one thing here. We have if, we have else. We also have else if. So this is to check another possibility. Let's do it like this. This block is, the else is like the last choice. We've only got two choices here, but we can have 20 choices, 20 questions. Did this happen? Did this happen? Did this happen? Or did that happen? Else is like the final result. Let's break, let's move this first starting else. Give yourself a couple of enters right there. Because we're going to ask another question before the final possibility. We're going to ask another possibility. So close that curly brace right there and open another one. So this curly brace used to close the if. Now move that down. We've got a new closing curly brace for the first if. And a new curly brace because we're going to ask a new question. And then the final closing curly braces for the final else. I guess I don't need that extra space there. Okay, so we have else if to ask a second possibility. If the possibility of hero greater than villain happens, we do that. Else if, should have called it or else. Else if. Another question. What if the powers equal to the following? I do need that space. Or else if. Another question. If that one is true, do the following. If this one is false, this one is false, all else fails, then we have the final result. The hero lost. Here's how we choose. Check if it's a draw. We're going to check random, power, hero, something here. versus random power villains. The something, the symbol,
is that it's equal. Is this number equal to that number? But we've used equal in a different way throughout all of our code.
And this actually, a simple equal here, will not work. In many languages like JavaScript, an equals is an assignment operator basically saying, put the thing on the right into the thing on the left. When we created these variables, make that random number and put it into or assign it to this variable. So plain old equals is an assignment operator. It takes the thing on the right, puts it into the thing on the left. And that's what we're about to do here, which is not correct. So we use a double equal, equal equal. This is two equal symbols next to each other, no space. Put a space there, this breaks. No equals. Now that double equals is a comparison operator. Let's compare this with this, and if it's equal, not a comparison, an equality operator. An equality operator. Is the thing on the left equal to the thing on the right? So two equal symbols. Say L div winner, winner HTML, equal. So that single equals is an assignment operator. And we'll say on screen a tie. Now we've got 99 numbers to choose from. It's going to be very hard to get that equal. If we lower it down to like 3, power levels of 3, you have more likely the chance to get the same value. To fully test this, let's check if this code is right, and then we're going to change our power level maximums to 3 to force this to happen more often. So else if. Check the first condition. If this is greater than this, character 1. Else if. Check something else. Is the powers the same? Tie. If none of those were true, it had to be false, or else everything fails. False. The villain. One. So again, you can probably spend a long time trying to see if 99 equals 99. Don't worry about it. Go back up to line 39 where you developed your power levels, where you determined your power levels. Random power hero, random villain, and just put 3. With 3 possibilities, you're going to get same values much more often than trying to get it from 99 power levels. First battle, Venom 1. Second battle, a tie. Invisible Woman versus Dr. Doom, 1-1. Another battle, Spider-Man 1. Another one, Squirrel Girl 1. Squirrel Girl 1 again, Venom 1. Another tie, Squirrel Girl versus Venom, 1-1. So, that was again showing, okay, in the real world, I would have thought of that. That could have been a tie. But because I never programmed it, we never programmed it originally, the computer would have never thought to do anything. I'm not exactly sure what would have happened on screen if there is an equality, if we hadn't programmed it. So we had to take the extra step again to help this poor, dumb computer think like us and do what we wanted to do. We did an equals. Is the power equal to the power? What's that? No result. It probably would have kept what was previously in the div. You know, if I had a win.
Actually, it would have done the else. It would have said the else, because all we said was if it's greater than, then it's this, but anything else.
Yeah, only dealing with true or false. So a 1 is not greater than a 1, so it would be a false. So yeah, it would have just defaulted to else, and we might not have realized it. But thinking one step ahead and think, well, what if there is a tie? we add an extra condition. And notice the syntax of that. So that curly brace closes the first if, then we have an else if to ask another condition, and then a final curly brace for the else block, if all else fails. Alright, any other questions on this project? I got it up to 73 lines with comments. Yes? Okay, I'll be there one moment. Let's take a quick look then at the final project. We'll have lab time the rest of the day. The final project is due tomorrow at 11. You have to turn it in person. The final day of class, you must be here in person to pass the class. It's school policy. You may have this completed right now, but you still have to turn it in tomorrow. Let's take a quick look at the homework, which is on Blackboard. I don't think I put it in the web design folder yet. Nope, so let's take a quick look at Blackboard. How many of you have already looked at the homework on Blackboard? I think 10 points for you, minus 10 for everyone else. It was there a few days ago. Let's go check out the homework. I'll break down what the homework is on Blackboard for a moment. We'll do lab time to get a little help. Again, I'm not giving the final code to you. Based on what we've done together, and with help, you can, with my help, you can get it all working. Let's see, final project. You go to Blackboard and you go to the assignments. Assignments screen, there is a brand new assignment. It might be a little obvious that it's the final assignment. It's nice and red. If you go look at that, so as usual, you create a folder with your last name and the project name. You can work based on what we've created together as this index file. You need a comment block at the end, so I know who to give the A+ to. Then it's going to be another character versus character. So I said any character versus any character. Create one array with at least 8 characters versus an array with at least 8 other characters. We did it with 3 characters. One step outside the box is to set up some character versus some characters, 8 of them. You know, character. You could do teams. Football team versus football teams. Horror movie characters versus horror movie characters. Whatever. Create an event listener that responds to a button press. So you have to press a button to do your result. Then a function that selects a different character from the array, generates a random number for its power, compares those numbers, determine who wins that matchup, and display that on screen. That's everything we've done so far. And then one little piece extra here, CSS. You're going to write some CSS embedded in the file, so in a style block. So you can write that, obviously, but in a style block. Style your project a little bit. Background color, text color, H1 color. Nothing too fancy. Just instead of boring black and white text, color it up a little bit. You do have to upload it to your FTP account, but you still have to come in person on the final day. Project is worth 20 points. By 11 on Wednesday, and you'll have today to work on it, and then tomorrow, and tomorrow I have one final unrelated lecture, and then the class ends. That's the final project.